Very good morning to all. I take this opportunity for the subsequent program which is run by the Department of Computer Science and Engineering in the Technical Fest 6.0. And today we are going to see a very crucial topic which is mostly needed in this situation, especially for the curriculum which what we have been presently available. So the topic today we are going to take is actually the virtual lab, which is a topic which mostly taken about the simulations as well as the virtual, how the labs can able to handle and how the lab can able to learn by the faculty as well as the students. So the government has taken an initiative and take a portal known as an vlab.co.in, so which is coming under the Government of India initiatives by the MHRD, which is called as an Ministry of Human Resource Development. So what is that MHRD is an the abbreviation is Ministry of Human Resource Development, is an responsible for the implementation and formulation of national policy on educations. So whatever the policies related to the educations which has been decided by the Government of India, which is a sector of known as an MHRD. And as a brief note about an MHRD, is being started in September 26 in 1985. And total annual budget for allocation for the India, especially to the formulation and implementation of national policy on education, is around 99,000 crores has been implemented every year. At present, we are having around of US dollars of 14 billions of amounts is being implemented or used for the implementation of national policies or educations. So this much of initiative is being taken by the government related to the educations, especially to the labs actually. So let me see about what is virtual lab. So at present, all of them are taking the semester exams to be shortly on next month, that is on January. So subsequently, we have the labs. So how to practice the labs in virtual, because we are all in the pathetic situation of this COVID-19. So even though the faculty has been taking through the online, the implementation process, but in what way I can able to use the software, because I've not installed the software, the packages will not be supported for me, or the understanding purpose which is taken for the simulation. So we need multiple demos, we need some experiments, we want to know what is the objective of the experiment. So all these things are all necessary once if you go for doing any kind of lab exercises. So all this kind of activities will be satisfied the virtual lab. For example, when you are writing an observation for any lab, so you will put an aim as well as followed by an algorithm and followed by the program and what is the procedure to run the program. So all these things will be identified, then you enter into the program to do it. So the same way the virtual lab is giving an environment for you to know about the, even starting from the basics of your core stream and to the advanced level, all the implementation can able to done it using the virtual labs. So let me see about the details about the virtual labs. So what is about the virtual lab? It is a project initiated by the Minister of Human Resource Development, Government of India, under the National Mission on Education through the Information and Communication Technology. So that what we will call it as an Information and Communication Technology will take more kind of initiatives, especially in virtual labs. So when you want to taken about this initiative through the portal, we have a proper URL is given for us, www.vlab.co.in. So using this particular URL, you can able to enter into the a stream of virtual labs based upon the stream that you have been developed. And the stream is not related only to the engineering, it is related to arts and science, polytechnic or school level. So all the broad areas has been taken initiative by the MHRD as a government of initiatives, which is done under the National Mission on Education through the Information and Communication Technology. So this virtual labs will carry about in the what way the observation we have been carried out. We have a aim, we have an objective, we know what is the procedure to do the lab exercises, and how the demonstration is given for it. The demo will be given for you, and as well as there is a practice exercise will be given for you, and there is a two kinds of tests will be given for you. One we called as a pre-test as well as a post-test. That is before entering into the subject or before entering into the topic, what is the knowledge, the basic knowledge you are having on the topic, and after doing all the experiments and the demos and exercises that you done it on train using the VLabs, that's what we called as in virtual labs. And after that, what is the post-test knowledge you are having. So all this kind of incredence has been completely packed and given to you, and it is very useful useful portal, especially for students as well as for the faculties to develop their own initiatives or projects, not only the curriculum of projects. So for example, if you take about the seventh semester of computer science and department, they are having a lab known as a security lab, which what year we called as a cryptography lab we are having. And as well as for the second year, we have in the digital principle and system design related to the microprocessor, or third year they are having a microprocessor. So all the implementations have been coming to the virtual areas, and you can able to practice over it, and you can able to gain the knowledge in different aspects, especially in pre-test and as well as the post-test, and as well as the demonstration is keenly given for you. And as well as for the second year students, for the data structures, they are given a beautiful concepts related to sorting, like a bubble sort, merge sort, selection sorts, what is the tree travels, so expression. So all the things are given in a fine way manner, and by step by step the process you can able to go one by one to know about what is the step one initialization or step one process, step two the process. So all these kind of activities you can make it by your own speed. So here the speed limit is also given for you. So slowly you can able to analyze what is each and every part is being carrying out. So all this kind of things and all available. So students, please use of this particular vlabs.co.in. And also, if I want to increase my communication, because communication is one of the main thing which is needed when you want to go to an any kind of an corporate, or when you want to be an entrepreneur. So that is a very important character which is needed for an any kind of an professional. So even if you can increase the communication skills, even the communication labs, whatever the subsequent labs that you are taken, so all the implementation of listening or grammatical terms, or you can have the subject, verb, object. So like this, of all the grammatical things and all, you can also learn it in practically by using this virtual labs actually. So this virtual labs will taken in different dimensions, especially in today's situation. So let me see what is the objective of the virtual labs. So virtual lab providing the remote access to labs in various discipline of science and engineering. And this virtual labs would cater to students at the undergraduate level or postgraduate level, as well as to the research scholars. So this lab will providing a 24/7 access to you. So it's not like a physical lab that you have been coming to the college and using over for 3 hours, 4 hours. So it is a remote lab. As a virtual lab, so this is a 24/7. You can access at any time, at anywhere, as you like. And this has been especially designed for the UG level, PG level students, even the research scholars, those who are doing a research in the area of for science and technology and engineering. So you can use this virtual labs for understanding the demonstration, what is internally happening in the system. So it avails the various tools for learning, including additional web resources, video lectures, animated demonstrations, and self-evaluations. So all this thing to be combinedly available in virtual labs. Maybe the line that they have been mentioned about the animated demonstration, the beautiful demonstration is given on each and every topic. Especially when I having experience, I can go through the data structures, which is having a beautiful experience on demonstration about the sorting methods, and as well as the in case of artificial intelligence, the speech learning process, how the text is being converted to speech by segregating the given information. So all this small things also, but the basic thing is very important to understand all the real-time work, so that all things to be taken in animated demonstration. And self-evaluation, we talk about the self-evaluation, each and every experiments, when you talk about the each and every experiments, will have the self-evaluation of your pre-test as well as a post-test. So this is very important to know about what is the weightage and what way, whether we are satisfied with the labs which you have been developed, and also the feedback is given for you. Not only the self-evaluation, the feedback is also given for you, so that you can able to give any kind of additional improvements you can given for this vLabs. So maybe one thing I want to carry out on this particular presentation, this vLabs is not only to be stopped with science and engineering, and for the UG level and PG level, as well as for the research level, even to the school level. I want to know some concepts which I want to know very clearly in physics and chemistry, or in the mathematics, or in English. That is the school level, whatever I've been studied. I want to have a recap on that particular experiments, which is needed for my PG level or UG level experiment. So even that also you can go for it. So it's not carried only for the professionals as well as for the undergraduate levels or PG levels. Even for the school levels also, the virtual labs which has been developed by an MHRD, which has been crucially needed. So that is why when I go through that kinds of websites, we will have a demonstration on this particular session. So it's really giving a basic knowledge to be very clearly on the science and engineering. So what is mean by virtual lab? So a virtual laboratory is a computer based activity where students interact with an experimental apparatus or other activity via the computer interface. So where the virtual laboratory is an on-screen simulator or a calculator that helps to test ideas and observe the results. Because whatever the experiments that you do it physically in the lab over, so that you are taking to the simulator. Okay, so we know what is a simulator actually. So the real-time implementation that we've taken to a virtual mode, okay, and calculate the help of ideas and as well as observe the results which is happening over the system. So you want to know some basic knowledge in the system side to and as well as the instructions to be given and what kind of input we want to give it, what kind of expected output we will receive. So all kind of these activities will be carried out in the virtual labs actually. And these are all the broad areas where the virtual labs is being presently implemented. And I think we have the core areas starting from the engineering to the science is being implemented, starting from electronics and communication and computer science and engineering, electrical engineering and mechanical engineering, chemical engineering, in biotechnology and biomedical engineering. So when you go for biotechnology and biomedical engineering and all, they've given a good examples of simulations even in civil engineering and as well as the physical sciences, which is related to when humanities and science, where you can able to learn all the even it started with your English communication, everything will be coming under your physical science as well as your chemical science. So all these broad areas will be packed with given in one particular portal, which what we call as in vlab.co.in. So you can use these initiatives. And before going to the demo, let me understand about what we are going to do with it. So see, basically you just take it one thing, you want to go through the concepts. First of all, you want to go through the concepts that what the topic that you are going to carry out. So based upon your stream, suppose I've been coming from computer science, then I can have different kinds of labs related to me. For example, data structures or a Python programming lab or an HTML lab, that what we call as a web technology lab, or we having a security labs, or we having a compiler lab. So all these things are available in each and every sector. Suppose if I've been from final year, then you can go and search where the security lab related to cryptography is available, and you know about the basic knowledges or basic the curriculum which says for you like a cryptography starting from your Caesar cipher and followed by an advanced encryption standard algorithm, symmetric encryption standard algorithm, and as well as Diffie-Hellman key exchange algorithm, RSA algorithm, digital signature. So these are all the implementation topics which has been available in the security lab to your curriculum. So you can go through this, and we know about the basics of all this thing, and you can able to know the instructions which is given over. So if, when you start over the experiment, very clearly there are the different steps of layer is available. Let me go one by one. So first I will go to the demo on this. So first I will go for the demo. So let I open the browser and type the URL, which is vlabs.co.in. So once you type vlab.co.in, you can see the home page of virtual lab. It is an initiative of Ministry of Education under the National Mission on Education through an ICT. And you can come down where you can see the objectives as well as the salient features of that. And the broad areas where all the virtual labs is being implemented, you can see the different streams available. And very important things, you can see the sliding which is available with participating institutes in India. So like IIT Delhi, IIT Mumbai, IIT Kanpur, IIIT Hyderabad, Amirdha Vishwam, Vidyapeedam, so IIT Madras. So all this kind of top universities will take in responsibility for a nodal center for the implementation of virtual lab, not only for the implementation of virtual lab. So they also take a responsibility to train the faculties as well as the students in all sectors like engineering, in polytechnics, or as well as in the arts and science, to make their motive to be create the virtual labs in all the sectors actually. So they taken much more importance on creating all this kind of labs. So let me go and see about each and every streams area and as well as the respective lab in each and every part. For example, I'm just taking electronics and communication. So in electronics and communication, you can see at left hand side the representation of labs starting from digital application labs, digital logic design using gates, digital logic designs, advanced network technologies virtual lab. At right hand side, you can see who have been created this particular lab. like starting from IIT Mumbai and as well as IIT Delhi. So let me go for the first application, which is known as a digital application. In what way the digital application can help the students to know about the simulation which is available in the gates, like an OR, XOR, NOT, NAND gates and all. So let I click the digital application lab. So once if you go to the digital application lab, at left hand side, you can see about a topic like introduction, objectives, list of experiments, target audience, course alignment and feedbacks. So after finishing all this applications, which means that after making an experience of all the list of experiments, you can give the feedback, any kind of improvements are there or any kind of sharing information related to the experiment that you have learned, so that you can give it as a feedback. So let I go for an objective of this particular digital applications. So what is the objective is given over here in the sense, the lab is developed to provide the learner the understanding of basic logic gates and enable him to relate the logics to the real world application. So how this logic gates can be able to apply to the real world application. So let I go for the list of experiments. You can see the list of experiments, there are 14 experiments available, which is related to the real time examples has been taken. For example, the first one, which they given as a experiment is washing machine control using the basic AND and NOT gates. So how the AND gate and NOT gates can be used in the washing machine control. And the second experiment they given over to the basics of OR gate and its application in the industrial control. So let I go for this second one, basics of OR gate and its application in the industrial control. So this is a model of each and every experiment. For example, if you go to the physical lab in observation, we will write it about the aim as well as the algorithm, the procedures and the program or an any diagrammatical representation followed by the sample output and as well as the actual output that what you have received. The same way it has been designed, but it is a 24/7. So you so that you can review again and again what are all the results that you can get it. So you can be able to analyze the results. That is a very important aspect that you can experience in the virtual lab. So let me see at the left hand side, what are the menus which is given over there. So first one is aim, followed by the theory. So you can able to know the little bit of theory about the topic, about the OR gates and the application of industrial control, followed by the pretest. So pretest is very important. See, before going to the concept of an lab, so what is the basic knowledge you are having on this particular topic? So that's the pretest you can able to evaluate by yourself, and as well as the procedure to use this particular experiment that will be given in the procedures, followed by the simulation where you can able to see the implementation part, how it is work. And the next one we will take about the post test. After completing all this studying over the aim as well as the theory and as well as the procedures, after taking the simulations, how the post test will be made. So in post test, if you are getting what kind of marks, so that it be differ from the pre-test as well as the post test. So these two things are very essential ones if you go for experiment, so that you can have a weightage and know about what is the in what way you can understand this particular experiment, and followed by the reference and feedback. So let I go to the theory part. So in theory part, they given about what is industrial control system applications and what is the basics of OR gate. So any one input is high, the output will be high. That is the basic thing which is taken over here. If the both the inputs are low, then the output is low. So in what way this particular OR gate can able to apply to the industrial control system? For example, they taken in the real world, in a chemical process or an industrial plant, if one or more parameters exceed the safe limit, it is desirable that an alarm should be activated along with the productive measures such as the turning of the wall or shutting down the plant process. So this is possible by using an OR operation along with some additional circuitry. So they are come to say over that they have different kind of parameters is taken. So let me consider this particular example. They taken two parameters. One is temperature, second one is pressure. So any one of this parameter is being taken to be high. So in that situation, I'm just giving an alarm so that I maybe the process, I want to shut down the plant, or I want to give a tone of the wall. So any kind of activities related to the object will be defined. So let us consider example of industrial control system. In an industrial process, it may be desired that when the temperature and pressure exceed the safe limits, an alarm needs to be activated and the process need to be stopped. So let me go and see the simulation part. So before going to the simulation part, you can see that there is an high and low is given as a slider for the to know about the temperature variation level. So there will be some reference temperature will be taken as well as the reference pressure will be taken. So based on the reference pressure and reference temperature. So they will take the real time values. So once they exceed the values of reference, that what we called as in the threshold level. So in that situation, the alarm will make it so that you can able to stop the plant or shutting down the plant process, or you can able to turn off the valve. So that kind of activities you can do it. So let will go and see the simulation part. So once if you go for the simulation part, you can see a fine output is given over here, where the two slider is given for the two parameters. One is temperature and as well as the pressure. So two kinds of values is being given, low as well as high, for the both the temperature as well as the pressure. So first I will increase the temperature to some level. So when it reaches the above the value of the reference level, then automatically the alarm will be made so that any kind of problem which is facing, we can able to stop that, or we can able to turn off the valve which is going to be taken in the plant process. So you can see the example over here. So you can see that when I increase the temperature which has been greater the value of the reference, then automatically which will make an alarm should be made. So if the OR gate, what we have, if any one input is high, then automatically make an alarm to be on and make to stop the planting process. And even in the pressure also, you can able to see that. So this is the way the experiment you can able to know that how the industrial this in industrial application, how the OR gates can able to use it. So this is a good example they given over here. So let me go and see other kinds of experiments which is available in the digital applications. For example, you can see the fourth list of experiments which is given, basic NOT gate and its application, the fuel level indicators. So let me go and see this. So the same way the procedure is given over as an aim, what is the major objective of this particular experiment. So let me go to theory part. So what is NOT gate? So if the input is low, then the output is high. If the input is high, then the output is low. That is the general the level of output which is taken or produced in the NOT gate. So in what way the application is going to be needed in this sense, they are using the fuel level indicators. So let me see what way it has been used. When the fuel level drops below the reserve or the minimum level, which means that it is a 1/4 of the level of the tank, the level sensor gives the output as a logic high. So in that situation, the NOT gate produces a low output and the red LED glows to indicate this fuel status. So to simulate this variation in the fuel level in the tank, a slider is provided. So what they come to say is, over in the sense, there will be 1/4 of the level of the tank when it comes to the minimal level. So that is a 1/4. The level sensor gives an output as a logic high. So when it is giving us a output of a logic high, then the NOT gate will produce a low output. So in that situation, the LED will glows to indicate there is a fuel shortage in the dashboard, so that the user can able to understand that the fuel level is being the minimum that we want to pour an petrol or an fuel to be pour in the tank, so that you can able to know. So in what way that NOT gate is being used over in the automobile system, you can know it very clearly now. So let me go and see the simulation part. So in simulation part, you can see that the tank is being available with the sufficient fuel. When I increase the level of slider, now the fuel is being increased. So when I come to the 1/4 of the level, when I reach the 1/4 of the level, then automatically you can able to see that the level of that LED is being glowing out and giving us indication in the dashboard that the fuel level is being 1/4 of the level, so that you want to pour in the tank the fuel. So that the information that is being given, so you can see over here, when it has been coming to the 1/4 of the level of the tank A, then automatically it makes the LED to glow, which give an indication to the user that we want to fill up the tank. So like this, very different kinds of applications which has been available in digital applications, so you can use it. See, maybe in your curriculum, whatever the subjects we have been carried out, that is giving the experiments that whatever we are carried out, but as in the real time, this particular virtual lab is giving over in where and all the gates are used actually, because every experiments what that whatever you using over the sense, that will give the the truth table as well as some basic set of experiment that we needed. But what is the real-time implementation? So that is very important. So in real-time implementation, you can able to understand the concepts very clearly in what way you can able to carry out the digital applications labs to be used over it. So let I go to the next stream, which is computer science and engineering. So in computer science and engineering, you can see about there are multiple labs are given, which is crucially needed and also related to the syllabus what we are presently having in our curriculum. So for example, they given about the basics of HTML, where the students of information technology, they are studying about the web technology. So this particular lab will use for them to learn the knowledge, how the structuring of web layout is being made, how the tags are implemented. You can practice the tag, all the things in the basics of HTML lab, and as well as the soft computing tools, followed by the problem solving, that is very interesting lab, and followed by data structure, because I have some little bit of experience when I work it with the virtual lab in the data structures, which is giving a clean idea about the different way of sorting, like merge sort, quick sort, bubble sort, selection sort. So you can able to know the variations in which is a better one, how many comparison is being made in the array, and how many swappings is being made. So how many looping is being made. So like that, you can able to take a part by part investigation, you can done it in this sorting. And followed by, you can have data structures two, which is getting another level of higher to the data structures one. And you can see pattern recognition lab, even for the computer architecture and organization, that is being used for the fourth semester students of computer science and as well as information technology students to knowledge in the architecture as well as the organization. And followed by, you can also see computer programming language, which is mostly used for the first year students to know the basic level of programming language, the flow control, or how the pointers are used, how the structures are developed, and how the variables are used. So all this kind of basic levels of transformations, you can see it in the computer programming lab. Followed by, you can see computer graphics lab, that is also used for the computer science student as well as information technology. So you can see at the bottom, that is a cryptography lab, which has been mostly used for the seventh semester students of CSE as well as an IT. This lab, which what we call as a security lab. So once if you go for the cryptography lab, where the different kinds of topics like your Caesar cipher or classical crypto systems, we can go for symmetric encryption, like an advanced encryption standard or a data encryption standard, Diffie-Hellman key exchange as a public key crypto system. There are different public key crypto systems available, and RSA algorithms, followed by we can go for digital signatures, message authentication code. So like the different topics are available with a theory explanation, which what you studied in the William Starlings of the cryptography and network security. But this virtual lab, which carrying about the cryptography lab, will give you the real time of implementation, how the values are developed, how the generator is made, what kind of prime numbers we can able to make it, how the encryption process is done, and how the decryption process is being evaluated. So all these kind of activities are you can able to see it in the cryptography lab. So what we see one by one. So first of all, I go to the first experiment, which is given is basics of HTML lab. So once if you go to the basics of HTML lab, where you can able to see about the objectives as well as a list of experiments, like and we have it. So let go to the list of experiments. So there are given 10 experiments to be available in the basics of HTML, starting from introduction to HTML, applying an attributes in HTML, how you can able to insert an images through the image tags, and as well as how the tables are created, and how the web page layout is created. That is very important one. So we will see one by one. For example, let I take inserting images through the IMG tag. So let we all know about an IMG tag, which has been mainly used for the purpose of inserting any image in the web, website through an HTML language. So let I go for the simulation page directly. So in simulation, you can able to see about the area where I want to insert the image. At the bottom, they have designed very beautifully actually, because why? In the sense, in right hand side, they given a syntax. Left hand side, they give an opportunity to fill the values. At the top, you can see the action. So syntax is in one end, implement is in one end, and at the top you can see the output, which is able to make it in the implementation part. So you can see image. So before that, you can go and see the syntax, what the syntax says for us. So the syntax is given img image src source, and we want to give the image path where the image exactly it has been available, and followed by the width and height. We can able to make it in the pixel as well as in the percentage, that depends upon the image. So Let me go and choose a file. So once I choose a file, I can take it from the local drive, or I can able to share it from any external drive also. So let I take it the symbol of virtual lab itself to be as an image. And once I make the image, and you can able to give the other kinds of attributes, you can able to give it, and what kind of border you needed, what is the width, and as well as an height is needed. And so let make it submit. So once if we go for submit, at the top you can able to see the result. So once I go for submit, you can able to see that the virtual lab, the icon is being placed by using the image tag. So very clearly they given over the experiment level of work that because syntax is more important while you are implementing this kind of tags. So they clearly identify and give it for the user experience, like right hand side to be a syntax, left hand side we visualize the input we given, at the top they given as output. So this structuring is very beautiful to work for it. And we will go to the other experiments which is available over in the HTML. For example, you can see the last one, which is creating a web page layout in HTML. So once if you go for creating a web page layout, in the sense, because layout is very important, once if you are going for a responsive website, once if you go for designing. So I go to the simulation. So in the simulation part, they given about three areas. One is a start, where I want to make it, what kind of sections I want to make it out. For that, there is a particular code will be generated. So that will be make it at the bottom. At right hand inside the area which is given for you, that we call as an your web page layout, will appear here. So this area is able to give the complete layout of the web page. So let I go for start. So once I start, it giving the parameters which is needed to develop over the overall web page layout. So I just go for add. So once I add it, you can see at the bottom the coding which we implemented, and in right hand side the designing part. So let I go to the next one, which will take it the menus, header, images, content, as well as footer. So these are all the basic thing the web layout will have it over it. So in header part, we will have a logo as well as the name of the web page, or an any kind of an institute's names, we will give it in the header. Menu bars, we will give the link to each and every pages that we can able to make it. In images, we go for some kind of sliders related to the institute or an any kind of organization to know about the infrastructures, they are sliding and all, we can give it in images. In content, we can able to give the basic information about the institute or an organization. So followed by, you can also give the footer. So you can see added, where you can able to see that in each and every when I go and press the add button, at the bottom you can able to see over the coding which I've been developed, and automatically you can see at the right hand side the design part. So it will make it one by one, and you can see the images, and the content will be divided into two. Finally, the footer is being developed. Yeah, the web page layout is being created successfully. So you can able to know the structure of a web page layout at an instant of time, and you can able to understand the concepts how it is being developed. Even the coding was also given at the bottom, so that you can easily understand this particular concept. So let I go to the stream of computer science and engineering again. Let I go for data structures one lab. So in data structures one lab, what already I just told about this, give the main kind of labs experiments, like your sorting or graph tree, stack and queue, searching, listed list. So all these things to be available. So you can go by one by one to know about that. For example, in sorting, I go for merge sort. So in merge sort, I just want to learn it. What is the estimation time that I needed to work it for the merge sort, followed by you can get some basic introduction video about how the merge sorts would work, and the prerequisites for the experiment. So what is the basic knowledge you needed before you are going to use it, the merge sort? So that is very important. Say given the concept of binary tree, you want to know it. You want to know the notation of sorting. You want to know the basic of logarithm. So these are all the different kinds of the prerequisites which is needed before using out the concepts of your merge sort. So at the left hand side, you can see the pretest, divide and conquer, the topics which is available, merge sort algorithm, analysis and post test, followed by the reference or feedbacks. So let I go for merge sort algorithm. Within that, you can see the concept of merge sort, demonstration of merge sort, practice of merge sort, exercises. We can do the exercises. Once you know the demonstration and practices, you can do the exercises. And finally, you can do the quiz also, so that you can able to evaluate the experience that you gain knowledge in the merge sort. So for example, let I go to the demonstration of the merge sort. where you can able to see about the demonstration which is giving the basic introduction as well as the instruction which is going here. So click the setup to draw the canvas and start up the experiment. So click the setup and as well as press next to go ahead the visualization. So once I press the next, automatically you can see the observation which is made it. Select the entire array, and this array will be divided into two parts. Then and so on, split the selector array as evenly as possible. Again, this will be evenly selected, distributed, so that you can see the swapping method which has been needed over here. So likewise, the process will be taken, and very clearly we can able to identify in what way the merge sort will be implemented. So like that, you can also do the sorting for all the peoples actually, which will help you to know about the concepts very clearly, that you can able to identify, and you can able to utilize it actually. Followed by, you can have data structures lab and as well as the architecture. So you can able to practice all this thing. Let I go to computer programming lab, which has been use it for the first year students actually. So here you can able to see the computer programming lab. You can see the functions and as well as the advanced control flow. Advanced control flow will level about how the for loops are made at each and every one, how the while loops are implemented. So all these things you can able to make it, the array implementation followed by structures, basic control flow like an if conditional, conditional statements, if then else statements, and followed by pointers, recursions, and so on. So let me take any one of the topic. Let me see how we can able to understand this concept. Let me go for pointers. So when you go for pointers, they're given about the clean introduction about the pointers in theory, how the pointers are implemented, how the storage of address will be taken. Even the address is not an address, the address will go and point out the content of the particular location. In that location, if you go there, where you can get the address. So this is the topic or the concept behind the pointers actually. So you can see at the top right hand side there is an video icon. So once you click a video icon, you can see the simulation of call by value as well as in call by reference. So in the call by value, you can see very beautiful layout is given for you. In the left hand side, the program is given. In the right hand side, the memory area has been given for you, where the memory will be allotted in byte 1, byte 2, byte 3, and byte 4, followed by the variable. And the address of each and every one is given over there. And the code output, you can see it at the bottom in left hand side. In right hand side, you can see the explanation of each and every one. So let I go for start. So initially, it is available in the header file. So please make it to be click the next button one by one so that you can able to analyze each and every line in a sequence manner. So followed by main function, and initially the A is being taken so that you can see the right hand side, the memory map, the variable A, which is being stored in the byte 4 of the value 410, and which is available in the address 60. So make it this particular address 60, because based on this address locations only, we are going to point out the values with the variable name which is given over here. So let's go to the next one. So now I've been taking at the value of A is being 10, so that you can see the code output at the bottom side as well as at the right hand side the explanation which is given for them. Click next. Again, what is the address of A? Because the address of A, which is available in the byte 4 and the 10, the address of A is actually 60. Okay, so again press next button. It go to the next line of the pointer startup. Then one by one, then the address of the value is being passed. So that 60 is being passed to the byte address, which representing the location of this is not a value, this is an address. This address is holding the value of 10. So that should be known by the next instruction. So I'm giving the pointer P. So it is giving only the address, not the actual value which has been related to the address. So that subsequently will be given over it. So what is the address of P in the sense where this the 60, the P, the pointer we just mentioned that is being available in the address of 56, followed by the actual location will be taken. Now you can see that the value at address P is 10, where the 60 will be referred. From the 60, we are taking the value A. Again, we go for changing the value of an pointer P, which will able to change the value of an A. So that once if you go to cross this level, you can see that now the value of A will be become as 20 instead of 10. So this is what the concept which is being taken as a new value will be assigned for that particular location. So this is what we called as a call by value. So you can see that the step by step method where you can able to avail very clearly, you can understand the concepts. So other than this, you can also go for home. Even the very crucial one, where that every students will need over this particular lab to be to make about their enrich in the communication skills. Let I go to physical science. So in the physical science, when you come down in the different set of labs, you can see one particular lab known as a virtual lab and communication lab. So please click on this particular lab. So you can get it over the screen over here, which contain the different set of labs, starting from business communications, common errors in English, communication skills, grammar, technical communication, vocabulary, reading and comprehension, listening skills. So like the different kinds of things is given to you, where you can able to improve your communication using this kind of before you are going for an any HR interview. So you can able to update your knowledge, especially in the communications. For example, I'm just going for listening skills. So in listening skills, you can able to see the theory, procedures and self-evaluation. So go to self-evaluation, where you can see the passage. You want to listen the passage. Once you listen the passage, after that, the questions will be asked by you. So this is the learning purpose, as well as you in what way your memory power has been having to listen over the concept. Based on the listening concept, the question will be asked. So the same thing what the interview process will be having on listening the questions from the HR as well as from the technical aspects, technical people, in what way we will answer to the particular question is very important for your placements. So let I go for experiment on any one of this. For example, the passage one, we have a listen. So once if you go for a listen, so you can, so so you can able to see that they given over the listening skill of this particular passage, and you can go for solve the questions. Nirupama was allowed to skip her school or a class or a kindergarten and nothing. So I think school, I think so, because that in while I listening the particular word, the girl Nirupama was allowed to skip her school only, I think. So like that, you can able to listen the concept and you can able to answer for this particular question. So try to utilize this particular lab also. So try to use this and make it to empower. And as well as very important thing is like what the experiments that we have seen over that, in what way this experiments can able to use it in the industrial system, that is a real-time applications. So that definitely you can able to enrich the knowledge on this particular virtual lab. So use it over. And also if you want to have some kind of basic knowledges that you want to need it in the school level, so that you can go for olabs.edu.in. So definitely that is also taken much more importance. And other most things that every common student, maybe in any kind of stream that you will have it, please go through the physical sciences. In the physical sciences, where we have a virtual communication lab, which carry about the listening skills and grammaticals and other kind of additional skills also given over there. So try to utilize and use the virtual lab. So let I complete the session. So thanks for giving this opportunity and for your patience to listen over the virtual lab. So let I will make of end of this session. And I will invite the next speaker, Mr. Praveen from final year Department of Computer Science and Engineering. And he's one of the trainee of Micro team for teaching the IoT based projects using the Microbit for the school students. He is one of the trainer, and he is having some basic knowledge in Android Studio, and as well as he's recently done an workshop in AI. So I think he's having basic knowledge in artificial intelligence as well as some kind of knowledge on deep learning and machine learning. Okay, so I invite the Praveen from final year Department of Computer Science Engineering to carry out the session of artificial intelligence. Before that, I'm just thank to all for you to make this session to be useful. So for further information related to the program, if you want to know it, you can go through the website which is displayed in the bottom of the screen. that is www.arunai.org/stem. So this is the program which is being mainly developed, how to become an entrepreneur or how to make ourselves to be empowered in the technology level. So this is a program which has been taking a healthy relationship between the faculty as well as the students. So both faculty in all the streams as well as the students can utilize this particular stream, and you can able to enrich the knowledge where that you can share the knowledge so that we can able to widely develop our skills available in this pathetic situations. So this is a subsequent programs which has been held in every 15 days in a month. So you will get 2 slots to be given in a month. So you can carry out, you can able to, there is the form is given for you where you can able to make your topics that you are preferred to go for it. And you can also copy the slides or you can attach the slides. We will review it. So once if you are sufficiently make it all the requirements which is given over in the form, you are supposed to take over the presentation. And you can contact the head of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering or the coordinators which is given over there in the website of www.arunai.org. So you can also go through that particular website. So use this opportunity, and thank you. And let I introduce the next speaker to take care about the artificial intelligence. And the speaker is Mr. Praveen from Final Year Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Aruna Engineering College. And he is one of the trainer in our micro team who has been taken more level of microbits projects for the school level students. And he's also having a basic knowledge in Android Studio. And he's been recently attended more workshops related to AI, and especially attended the topics which is related to machine learning as well as the deep learning. And he's also having mainly on the artificial narrow intelligence. So let I invite Praveen to share his presentation on artificial intelligence, to share his knowledge.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for this opportunity. Hello everyone, I am Praveen, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Final Year Arunai Engineering College. In this session, we are going to discuss about artificial intelligence or AI. The term artificial intelligence refers to the technique that enables machines to mimic human behavior. Artificial intelligence is a theory and development of computer system able to perform tasks normally requiring human intelligence, such as visual perceptions, speech recognitions, decision making, translation between languages. Such as AI is a simulation of human intelligence done by machines programmed by us. The machine need to learn how to reason and do some self-correction as needed along the way. And artificial intelligence is accomplished by studying how human brains think, learn, decides and work while trying to solve a problem, and using this outcome of the study as a basis of developing intelligence software and systems. Let briefly see about the history of artificial intelligence. The year 1950 is known as the time when it all started. In 1955, John McCarthy coined the term artificial intelligence. In 1974, computer became faster and affordable in price. In 1980, the era of artificial intelligence came into existence. And the artificial intelligence landmarked its establishment in 2000s. This is the brief history of artificial intelligence. The first step toward artificial neural networks came in 1943 when Baron McCulloch, a neuropsychologist and a young mathematician, wrote a paper on how neuron might work. Nathaniel Roester from the IBM Research Laboratories led the first effort to stimulate a neural network. But the first attempt failed, but later attempts were successful. It was during this time that traditional computing began to flower, and as it did, the emphasis in computing left the neural research in the background. The Turing test, originally called the imitation game by Alan Turing in 1950, it is a test of machine's ability to exhibit intelligent behavior equivalent to or from that of a human. If the evaluator cannot reliably tell the machine from the human, the machine is said to have passed the test. In 1956, in the DEMOT conference, which was organized by Marvin Minsky and John McCarthy, AI gained its name, its mission, its success, and its major players. And the year is known as the birth of AI. The first chatbot was developed in 1966 at MIT. They called it as Eliza. Eliza, the mother of all chatbots, answered some very simple decision, 3 questions. The first chatbot iteration has since evolved and deployed naturally. Waseda University started the WebArt project in 1967. WebArt 1 robot was completed in 1972 and was the world's first full-scale android humanoid robot. It was the first robot to able to walk and communicate with people in Japanese, navigate a room, and grip and transport objects. Nearly 20 years ago, IBM's Deep Blue computer stunned the world by becoming the first machine to beat reigning world chess champion in a 6-game match. iRobot inspired the first micro rover used by NASA, changing space travel forever, deployed the first ground robots used by US forces in conflict, brought the first self-navigating FDA-approved remote presence robot to hospital, and introduced the first practical home robot with Roomba. Watson is a question-answering computer system capable of answering questions posed in natural language, developed in IBM's Deep QA project by a research team led by principal investigator David Ferrucci. Then, Eugen Goostban is a chatbot that some regard as having a passed the Turing test. Turing test is a computer ability to communicate intuitively from a human. Finally, we all know about Amazon's Alexa, which is also known as Alexa, is a virtual assistant AI technology developed by Amazon, first used in Amazon Echo smart speakers developed by Amazon Lab 126. It is capable of voice interaction, music playback, making to-do list, setting alarms, streaming broadcast, playing audiobooks, and providing weather, traffic, sports, and other real-time information such as news, etc. Now let's see types of artificial intelligence. Artificial intelligence types are categorized into two categories. They are based on ability and based on functionality. Before going deep into the artificial intelligence, let me clear a basic confusion of artificial intelligence. People think that artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning are the same, but it isn't. Artificial intelligence is the science of getting machines to mimic the behavior of a human, whereas machine learning is the subset of AI that focus on getting machines to make decisions by feeding them data. Deep learning is a subset of machine learning that uses the concept of neural network to solve complex problems. Finally, artificial intelligence, machine learning, and deep learning are interconnected fields. Machine learning and deep learning aids artificial intelligence by providing a set of algorithms and neural networks to solve the data-driven problems. But artificial intelligence doesn't restricted with this machine learning and deep learning. The domain of artificial intelligence is really much more. For example, it can detect object detection, robotics, natural language processing, and expert system, and so on. Now let's back into the types of artificial intelligence based on ability and based on functionality. In based on ability, it is categorized into three types. They are narrow AI, general AI, and the super AI. In case of based on functionality, it is divided into four types. They are reactive machines, limited memory, theory of mind, and self-awareness. These are the types of artificial intelligence. Now let's see briefly about based on ability types. Artificial narrow intelligence, ANI, is also known as weak AI, involves applying AI only to specific tasks. For example, let's take Alexa. Alexa is a simple artificial narrow intelligence example which can perform its projects like which are predefined. For example, Alexa can turn on lights. If you are connected a smart device with it, it can turn on lights. You can search some basic questions like what is the time now, what is the day today, who invented the something. We can do all the stuff with Amazon Alexa, but this is a weak AI which comes under artificial narrow intelligence. Now let's take artificial general intelligence, whereas artificial general intelligence, also known as strong AI, that involves machines that possess the ability to perform any intellectual task that a human being can. We all know him, he is Stephen Hawking. He says that strong AI would take off on its own and redesign itself at an ever-increasing rate. Humans who are limited by slow biological evolution couldn't compete and would be superseded. Artificial intelligence, most powerful one is artificial superintelligence. Artificial superintelligence is a term referring to the time when the capability of computers will surpass humans. We all know him too, he is Elon Musk. He says that by the year of 2040, artificial intelligence will take over the world. He quoted that at least when there is an evil dictator, that human is going to die. But for an AI, there will be no death. It will live forever, and then we will have an immortal dictator from which we could never escape. Let's see simple applications of AI. Identifying the number of planets in solar system, which is 2500 light years away from. Composing simple music, AI can do anything. Let's take JP Morgan's Chase Contract Intelligence. It is a platform uses AI machines, learning and imagination software to analyze legal documents. It really analyzed 12,000 agreements within fraction of seconds. To manually review it, it would take 36,000 hours, which is really appreciable. IBM Watson is a healthcare organization that was worked with the AI. Millions of healthcare organizations use IBM's AI Watson technology. Currently, Google is working on AI Doctor program. AI Doctor can examine retina scan and identify a condition called diabetic retinopathy, which can cause blindness. With this software, we can identify this problem and solve it before the blindness problem. Now let's take Twitter. All the social media like Twitter, Facebook are using the AI. In Twitter, Twitter using AI to identify the hate speech and the terroristic language in Twitter. It uses the machine learning by identifying our face gestures. For example, take this message. What a great first day. Can't wait for the networking event tonight. It's a happy news, hence happy emoji shown. If there is an angry speech, our face will change. It will recognize it and change it. Report it to the Twitter. This company discovered and banned 3 lakh terrorist link accounts, 95% of which were found by non-human artificial intelligence machines. Now let's see the real demo. Search for links, AI demo. Click on this link. Click on install. So we are currently installing the setup of our AI. I have already downloaded the application, since it shows you already have the application, hence we cannot install.
Initial checks completed. Backing up the configuration. Initializing databases. Establishing connection to satellite number 81. Loading intro. Rendering main control center. Loading custom components. I am online and ready.
Hello.
Good morning, Praveen.
Jarvis.
How may I help?
Open Google.
Sure, here you go.
Open Facebook.
Opening Facebook.
Open YouTube.
Opening YouTube.
Check for new mails.
Opening Gmail.
Open Google.
Opening Google.
Read this.
Artificial intelligence, AI, is the branch of computer sciences that emphasizes the development of intelligence machines, thinking and working like humans. For example,
stop reading.
Speech recognition, fine.
Jarvis, goodbye.
Do you want to execute the AI shutdown protocol?
Yes.
Starting application shutdown sequence. Goodbye.
Thanks for the opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Praveen, for your startup related to the artificial intelligence and known about the history that you have been starting from the origin of artificial intelligence and come to today's, how it has been implemented and how it has been structured. And the demo that you given had some kind of simple issues, I think. So maybe we can take another opportunity for the forthcoming sessions on the STEM program and you can also give another good demonstration. But the knowledge that what you've been identified and the way that approach you've given on the topic is really good, and the presentation is also a neat presentation with the crispy input that you've given over. So thank you for all for this attending the STEM 6.0. So shortly we will have STEM 1.0. The students, those who are want to initiate it on this particular program, make your presentations or make your topics prior to the 15 days of the program. So get a concurrence from the head of the department as well as the faculty in charge. I given over Mr. Nurul Hasan. So you can also get a concurrence from both the people of head of the department as well as Mr. Nurul. Try to have this kind of implementation in the forthcoming month. So this is a way of knowledge of improvisation that we can able to make it. Today we get some kind of information related to AI. I really got admired from Praveen. He's given a good demonstration. But little bit of improvisation is needed that you can able to do it in the further improvement. So thank you, Praveen, as well as the backend. I want to tell about the backend people, those who have been working for here to do this program to be successfully. Mr. Rutna Kumar, as well as Mr. Sabari, who has been working for this STEM program to be the backend of the all this program. So I appreciated on Department of Computer Science Engineering and as well as on the student side. Students, those who are attended, really appreciated your interest that you showed on it. So in forthcoming sessions, we will expect all your cooperation to take it to the successive level. So once we reach STEM 10.0 successfully in the forthcoming months, we have planned to have a good speakers from especially from the corporate as well as from the IETs. So they have given a concurrences because this presentation is being posted to them to get a feedback and as well as a reputation from them. So that shortly we will speak with admiring people in our STEM program so that we will make it in STEM 10.0 shortly. So thank you all, and thank you Praveen, Rutna Kumar and Sabri for your back end support. Thank you.